What's up, guys, and welcome back to another video. What's up, guys? Today we're actually going to be installing everything in our truck as far as the system. We have everything that we need right here. So I'm going to be showing you step by step. Thank you for everybody that commented. We are going to be doing a detailed video. A lot of you guys have been commenting that you guys enjoy the detailed videos. I also put it on my Instagram, so make sure you guys follow me on my Instagram right here. You guys can see what I'm doing prior to doing this, because these videos are kind of released like a week later. So those of you guys that follow me have already seen how it sounds and have already seen pretty much everything. So let's get started. We're actually going to do, like I said, I'm going to put my GoPro on and try to show you as much detail as I can. I'm sorry if this video is like in two, three parts. I just want to show you guys. The main reason why I kind of want to show you guys what like detailed videos of this is because at once, man, when I was a kid, I did not know how to do any of this. And I wish it was like these kind of videos on YouTube so I can follow like step by step. So, but I'm here for you guys. So leave your questions down below in case I forget to answer one of your questions. But I want to try to be as specific as I can during this whole build here. So we're actually going to get started by removing as much of the interior as you can. That's the number one thing you want to get done, is make sure that you have ample space to install everything. I mean, you can do it. Not gonna lie, you can probably run everything without taking the seats. But to be honest, I want room so I can be back here and everything. Even though these seats go pretty much really low, honestly, look. And I can install, because we're gonna install our amp probably back here. But I'd rather have enough space, that way I can tuck everything nicely, and we can remove all this without any things in the way. So, all right, let's go ahead and get started by removing as much of the interior as we can. All right, guys, we're gonna be removing, looks like maybe two bolts on this side and maybe two bolts on the other side, hopefully. That's it, two and two bolts. And then we have to remove this seatbelt area to remove this back panel. But let's see what size sockets those are. I'm using a 15 socket here, guys. All right, let's put this down. All right, see, now we have a lot more room here. I did forget to take this out, guys, and I pulled on it. I'm gonna have to repin it. But I don't know, does this thing have like even a seatbelt light on? I don't even know if we need that, honestly. But let's go ahead and remove this part and then give this a little vacuum so we can look how nice that carpet used to be. We need to order a new carpet for this. It's not that bad, honestly. It just needs a little cleaning, but I don't like this. This part here is already worn out. So let's go ahead and remove. See, there's our original jack and everything. That's pretty neat, honestly, that we have all that. But there's like a plastic thing, maybe for here. I don't know where this is from. But let's go ahead and remove that bolt there. What is that, like a 10 mil? All right, guys, it took me a while, but this little stud, I guess you need this little socket that goes in here. But all it is removing it, turning it to the lefty-loosey, you know? But it took me a while because I had to like press it, go a little bit, press it, go a little bit, let go. But look how nice the original carpet was. Like I said, we're gonna be ordering a brand new interior later on, not right now. Right now, we're just gonna remove, like I said, as many panels as I can. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just clean this, clean all this area up, because look at this, years and years of grime on this. I could give this carpet a little wash too, you know, while we're here. Might do that too. give it a little wash. Even though, again, we're gonna be changing out everything, but in the meantime, so it could look nice and clean. Now, I'm going to, can I remove this? It's on with some rivets, though. I have to remove this to remove this. Unless I can maneuver it around. Because then I have to remove this. So we have to remove the seat belts completely. This is a time-consuming part, honestly. I feel like actually installing the radio and doing all that, it's not that hard, but this is a time-consuming part. So let's go ahead and remove this. Alright. There we go, seat belts are completely out. Oh, these are all missing screws. What the hell? You guys might not have these screws. These definitely look aftermarket. If I would say so myself, definitely aftermarket screws. Whoa. Whoa. Oh, the window guy's glue just glued this part on. Now it's gonna break in pieces. Wow. So brittle. We'll try to glue this somehow outside the truck. I guess all these clips kind of broke over the years. This missing the screws too? No, this one's not missing the screws. Seems like all these panels were removed at one point because we're missing screws here. All right, maybe all these will pop out. I gotta be real careful with this kind of stuff. No, this thing is like cracking everywhere. This thing's legit just cracking everywhere. This plastic is so brittle. Look, this part is cracking. All these parts are just so brittle. I don't know where this part came out of, but this part fell down somewhere. Oh my god. What is this? This for the speakers? That's all. This looks aftermarket, guys. What the heck is this? What is this? Is this for the speakers? Yeah, guys, comment down below. Is this stock or is this aftermarket? Look how clean the paint job is under, though. Damn, that's how original it was. I'm gonna remove all this wiring. We don't need any of this. We don't need any of this. But look at these little speakers that don't even work. We gotta get all this cleaned up. All right, guys, we got everything removed over here. I'm gonna take this crappy old wiring out. Let's take the speakers out. Yeah, let's take everything out as much as we can and then get all this cleaned up. Remove that side. And that's pretty much it. Let's go. Yeah. Just pull them, I guess. Alright. So, look at these little magnet here. Crap, yes. Speakers, I mean, these are all stock speakers. I guess this is a stock wiring. Look at that. All right, we're gonna move on to the other side. Take that off, take the bottom. I forgot there's absolutely no wires down here, which is gonna be very nice to tuck everything in. It's gonna give us a lot of space for our zero gauge wires, and our amp is probably gonna be right here. I'm gonna take this carpet out too to give us space here.
All right, let's take all this wiring out, guys. See, I knew it. I knew that they were, this is not stock. They had already replaced them. They had tapped into this already once. I don't know why. What was this old man doing? And they cut these off. Look. This is why we didn't have no sound. They cut these off. Where's this one at? Oh, this is for the dome light up there. Okay, that's for the dome light. But look at that. They had already spliced into our wiring here and put this on for some type of amp or something, I guess. They've already since put some type of amplifier or something here. Look at this. It's all the way to the other side. And they cut it. That's weird. This is the stock wiring, so I don't know. Maybe. I don't know if I should take this out or not. But I don't know why they cut it like that. This is this plug here. All right, let's take this plug out here. There we go. This is for our speakers here. There we go. That's for our speakers right here. All right, should we vacuum now? I think so. But I want to be removing all this, at least this bottom dash part, and then this part here to remove this part, and then to remove this. I don't think I need to remove this part. Maybe I do. No, I don't think it's attached there. I think we're okay. But let's grab our 7mm and remove as much as we can down here. This has already been cut also. What the heck happened here? See, I don't understand what this thing is for. What was it, a kill switch or something? I don't understand. We got a bunch of wires. It probably was a kill switch. We got a purple wire here, and it's in between the purple wire. It was a kill switch that they later took off. It was probably one of those Revelco things, because these are all black wires. Look. And this is tapped into this pink one. And then this one was tapped into something too. Let me know what you guys think. What was this for? Let's figure out what this one's for. Because this one's connected to the pink one. What is a pink one? Pink is an ignition harness. Ignition. Pink is ignition. Purple is starter. Ah. It was. This was some type of kill switch. We need to remove this part here. I'm guessing you just pull it. Yeah. Ooh. There we go. All right, you gotta be careful not to break anything, guys. Where's the plug for this? Here it is. All right, guys, the plug is down here for the radio. I think it goes to this amplifier looking thing. Well, I don't know what it goes to, but this is the plug for the radio. Let's go ahead and clean all this area up here. Give it a little dusting. This one looks nice. I actually like this, not gonna lie. I actually do like this. But anyways, moving along, I'm gonna go ahead and clean this area up here, dust it off, and we're gonna go to our workbench and wire up, either using the same one I can cut it off, or let's see our adapter. All right guys, off camera, I kind of cleaned up the majority of this stuff. I have a little brush here, and I use some of this aguasome, aka awesome spray. But you know, we're paisa, we say aguasome. And I clean most of this area. You can see it's nice and clean. I mean, as good as it's gonna get. I'm gonna make a detailed video later on, but this is what we have. Also right here, I was wrong. So the radio gets connected down here, and let me show you, into this little aparatito right here. I don't know, this little mechanism was down here, and like that, you pull this one out, and then you have the plugs that come from the radio, and then your actual wiring harness. So I compared it to the one that we have, and this one plugs into that one, so you can just fish it in from this area all the way up, and you can kind of see it here. It's like three plugs. Yeah, it's like three plugs, but I think I'm only gonna need like one or two out of these because we need to de-pin. I already took out some of the speaker wires. We're gonna look at our harness here. This is the one that comes with the kit that you buy. And then we have here, this is the rear. So we're gonna just pull these out because we're not gonna use them. So these two are for the rear speakers. And like I said, we're gonna bypass this whole setup. So we don't need these. We don't need the fronts. And then I think one of these other ones is the other rear. Right here, right rear is the purple ones. So we can take these out. And then, so we have this one, which is our constant battery. Then we have our ignition switched. And then we have, I think this is a dimmer. Yeah, dimmers. And then we have power antenna, which we don't have a power antenna, so I think we can take this one out. We won't take this one out because this one might work as a remote turn on. And then we have our ground. So we have all these that you're gonna need to wire to your stereo. So let me bring up the stereo and then I'll show you guys how to wire these up. And we're gonna solder all these connections so that we have a nice solid connection. All right guys, we're here on our workbench. I hope you guys can see clearly. So dirty, man. All right, so this is what comes. This is the one that we had in the OG, little short deck. And this is a little wiring harness. So like I said, we're not gonna be using all of these. I'm going to keep these. These are going to stay with the harness here. I'm not gonna de-pin these because you never know in the future if I end up putting this radio in another car and I do need these. So I'm gonna go ahead and just put these away like that. And we're just gonna, I'm gonna make sure that these are here in case we ever wanna use it for a different car. So this is pretty easy. This is the system remote control, so you don't need this one either. Actually, I should have put this one in there too. Well, we'll leave it like that. Okay, so these are the ones you guys are gonna need, and just match them up with the colors. So I'm just gonna cut them to make them the same length, so they're all the same length. All right, and then we're gonna just, let's open these up a little bit. So I'll show you guys how to solder here. If you all don't know, get yourself a good soldering iron. This solders really quick, and it is, it warms up fast. So that's what I like about it. So we're gonna take these out. So before you do anything, make sure you put some of this stuff, some of these, you know, here, and don't forget. So put them in first, otherwise there's not gonna be no way to get it into it. there first, and then we need one more. Okay, so align the colors. Blue is gonna be probably our remote turn on. We don't know if that works yet, but we're gonna kind of twist them together. Same thing with this one. Same thing with this one. Okay, we're ready to solder. So we'll start one by one. Let's get this one, see if it's ready. Yep, it's ready. So we're gonna, just gonna solder this one in here. Make sure there's plenty of solder all the way around it. Perfect. On to the next. There we go, perfect. On to the next. Then we're gonna test our radio to see if everything works. Oh, oh, get it out. Don't wanna. Okay, on to the next. And last one. Plenty of solder on there. Okay. And just like that, we're all done. Now, go ahead and put these over the connections like that to make them waterproof. Like that, like that. Okay. Like that. And then I like to use a lighter for a little torch. You can use a heat gun. I think it's preferably, it's better to use a heat gun because it distributes the heat a little bit more evenly. But I like to use a torch, whatever gives heat, you know? This is heat shrink. Ooh, I'm burning it. All right, there we have it. So like I said, I don't know if I need this or not, but this is pretty much set there. We're gonna take it a step further and we're just gonna wrap all of this together. This is called Tessa tape, and this is what they use in the factory, OEM stuff. So just Tessa tape it, something like that. Bam, perfect. This is how your wiring should look like. So I'm gonna connect the radio. It should just be plug and play, and our radio should turn on. This radio should 100% just turn on. Connected there in the back. In the back here, we also have our connections for our antenna, our RCAs, and microphone. I'm not gonna use a microphone. I never actually use it. And then we just connect these. I think it's just the one plug. Which plug is it? The blue one? I think it's this one. It's just gonna be one plug. Yeah, that black one there. All right, and then this blue one should be our remote turn on, but I don't know yet. So I'm gonna test that one to see if we have 12 volts there. And let's turn it on, see if we have power on our Pioneer. Yep, power. You guys see that? Let me test that lead to see if there's 12 volts there. There's not 12 volts there, so we're gonna have to get another remote turn on to turn that part on. Let me see here, is this 12 volts? Yep. But is this 12 volts all the time? Yeah, that's 12 volts at all times. Okay, so we're gonna have to get another accessory. So we can take this one out. Now that we saw that, let's take this one out. Take this one out. Bam. So we're gonna have to get our remote turned on somewhere else here. Probably from the same plug. We'll grab, I think it's a yellow wire. That's accessory. That'll be our remote turn on. We'll have to tap into that same one. But that's all it is. See you guys? So now that we got this, let's go ahead and put this in our, unplug this right here. And then let's install this in our dash kit.